Hey guys, welcome back to Channel Name Pending. I'm Manny, and today we are reacting to Avatar The Last Airbender on Netflix, Season 1, Episode 3, Omashu. Just a reminder that I have seen the original animated show, as I'm sure many of you have, but just in case you are watching Netflix's The Last Airbender without having seen the original source material, be warned that I do talk about the original show in my videos, so be prepared to be spoiled for potential future events. Before we continue the video, I just want to point out that 95.1% of you are watching my videos, but for some reason you're not subscribed to the channel. To the 4.9% of you who are subscribed, I love you. To the rest of you, I'm not mad, I'm just disappointed. But we're going to remedy that right now. Just scroll down, hit that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell so you know when my videos are coming out, and we can continue the video. You may have noticed that it's just me this time around. Sadly, Kaylee currently has a lot on her plate and isn't able to join me for reactions for the time being. Possibly, hopefully, I'll be able to have her on for later episodes, but the show must go on, so you're stuck with me for now. When last we left our heroes, we just left Kyoshi Island, where the gang met some new friends and Aang learned a little bit more about what it really means to be the Avatar. We will of course be visiting Omashu in this episode, and that means we will also be meeting King Bumi for the first time, and I'm just really excited for that, so without further ado, let's get into it.
We have hope. I want you to meet someone willing to risk everything for our cause.
These look like all of us. Fire Nation?
She's lost too much.
My mother and my brother in the siege of Ba Sing Se.
Wait a second.
She works at the palace. She's willing to help.
This isn't who I think it is
great
it?
Personal risk if she can summon the courage.
My mother and brother? Okay, so this seems to be some kind of Fire Nation rebellion, like an actual internal rebellion, which we never really saw in the original show, from what I remember. I'm not gonna say who I think this is, just in case I'm wrong and I end up sounding stupid, but if I'm right. I love the set design for the war room. It looks completely accurate to the show.
There is no way out. But you must have known this was a one-way journey. Are we not the greatest?
Already way more of Ozai than we saw in the first season of the cartoon.
Under one rule, our rule, to ensure an era of peace.
Tree of loss and suffering.
Ozai almost sounds like Mark Hamill too.
To me of loss.
It's not a one-to-one, but he's cast really well.
Then again, we in the Fire Nation.
Yeah, I am correct. This is Azula.
Isn't that right, Azula?
I'm
yes, Father.
So excited to see Azula and how the actress portrays her. One of my favorite characters from the original show.
You may have stopped us tonight, Ozai. The one who will restore balance to the world. The one who is returned.
You're all gonna die. Yeah. Holy shit. That reflection in her eyes.
The one who will restore balance to the world. Can you believe they think the Avatar has returned?
Leave us.
What's this?
A message from one of my commanders in the Southern Seas. No one of any importance. What he had to report, however.
Zuko has found the Avatar?
Zhao would have hated to hear that.
Impossible.
She is giving Azula. That first line was very, very Azula-esque.
Tap into your feelings and gather energy from them.
I remember in the cartoon, Aang or Katara got pissed off that Aang initially progressed a lot better at waterbending than she did. Just got a little competitive.
Wow. I bet it was my fault. I should never be a teacher. The monks always said I never listened.
That's one thing that is sort of lacking in this portrayal of Katara.
I never listened.
So far, I would say, is her temper. Katara in the cartoon was very, very quick to anger.
I might even listen to them.
Okay, it's time to go. We shouldn't stay in the same.
It was one of her most identifiable traits. Aww.
I think it's another airbender.
No, it's not.
He's headed for that mountain.
That's no mountain. That's Omashu.
That's when he left Kyoshi. I didn't see anything.
You'll need to stop for food and water.
I'll have to go back.
He may be the Avatar, but he still needs to eat and drink.
I don't like him.
Word is, Zhao failed his office training program 3 times.
Did I ask for your opinion?
My apologies.
Damn, Zuko. He's just trying to make you feel better.
He was only trying to help.
Yeah.
He was gossiping about a superior officer.
Rules.
To be fair, if he gossips about him, then he probably gossips about you.
Even out here.
For the world, actually. And they have an incredible delivery system that winds through the whole city.
Yeah, they do.
People there, they're artists, scientists, builders.
Oh my god. I'm sorry, I keep saying this, but like, it looks so true to the cartoon.
They don't take kindly to outsiders in Omashu.
What makes you think we're outsiders?
Is that who I think it is?
No reason.
Yeah, it is. Oh my god, it's Jet. I saw his casting a while back, and I just couldn't get over how perfect he looked for the role.
It's out of the turnip sack. I'm sure you can make that look good, too.
Jed always did have the best rids. Strongholds.
Hold there.
Where's his leaf?
Oh, wasn't a great crop this month.
Where are they hiding Aang?
She told me I wasn't.
Oh yeah, because he has his tattoos.
My brother-in-law would agree if he could speak.
Struck mute at birth.
You'd be amazed at how much you can say without words. Just the other day, he made us laugh so hard.
All right, that's enough. Move along.
Didn't even give him a chance. Oh, there's Aang. Yes. I really, really hope we get to see Aang ride those. Oh. Fuck the disguises right away, I guess. Okay. I guess we're already in. I would have kept them on.
And...
Hey, watch out for my kill!
Oh!
You're not an airbender.
Wow, we're just meeting everyone.
He's an airbender!
Yeah, that's a real airbender.
Mechanist?
Meeting the Mechanist and Teo this early, too.
Wastes a lot of time tinkering.
Don't listen to him. He's just
they really do have to condense the timeline, to be fair.
You've seen it, right?
But it's interesting that we meet them here instead of, you know,
play a small role.
The Air Temple. Also, the fact that the Mechanist is played by Abed.
Would be on their knees by now.
Cracks back home.
I do hope we get to see those storylines properly adapted in the future, though. Jet, the Mechanist. Because they're supposed to be holed up at the Air Temple. And the Mechanist is secretly serving the Fire Nation.
This place used to be incredible.
Under duress, but...
A place where amazing things were created. Because I'm the Avatar.
Is he...
Now tell me about these bombings.
He's done the impossible.
He's done nothing.
Ty Lee and me.
An ocean cruise while I've been here doing everything Father has asked.
So they're already with her?
Who's the one risking her life to root out traitors?
I wouldn't want to come back.
Yeah, well, all dear old Zuzu wants is to
pretty good May impression.
Take away everything.
Technically, he is first in line to be Fire Lord. Not that he deserves to be.
He doesn't. But now.
But I bet you want him to be.
There are always ways to get in the game. If you know which pieces to play.
Don't flatter yourself.
The Avatar has
you were never
returned.
Even a player.
My mother told me stories of the Avatar.
Forgot to mention this earlier, but I do know that the guy who played the Cabbage Guy was the same voice actor from the original cartoon, which is just really nice. Ooh. Mechanist up to no good. Yep. I'm kind of disappointed that this isn't taking place on the Air Temple.
What are you doing?
Shit.
But that means the Mechanist is a
traitor.
Wow, we are mixing a lot of storylines together right now.
They're in danger. I've got to warn them.
They'll be fine. Mechanist may be a turncoat, but he's a coward. He never take any direct action.
Uh-huh.
Wait.
I've always thought Jet's weapons were so
Who
cool.
Who are you?
You call me Jet.
That was a pretty good character shot. Wow, that is bold of them.
There's the cave.
Good thing about friends then.
Those guys are Earth Nation? Oh, I was wrong. Nice. Sick. Where's Jet's crew? I want to see Pipsqueak in them.
Oh yeah, I brought friends too.
The Duke. There he is. I'm not over how accurate the costumes are.
Awesome shooting there, Longshot.
Yes.
Who are you people?
Freedom fighters.
We're the good guys.
I wouldn't say that. Well,
you coming?
There it is. They waited just so they could tease me.
Here, an event here. All you need to do is install a bleed valve to regulate pressure.
So far, this episode is a mishmash of.
Don't get me wrong, he's incredible. After the fire, he's
three different episodes from the original cartoon without the actual original plot of the episode it's supposed to be based on, which involved King Bumi.
Do you want to do more?
Which makes me wonder if we're going to let these play out and meet King Bumi instead in the next episode.
Here, look. If you mix Tinkar with salt water and then boil it down, you get this. Blasting jelly. A few jars could blow half the neighborhood sky high. What'd you find?
You never told how to make blasting jelly in the original cartoon, so that's a pretty cool detail.
The firebenders weren't behind the explosion.
My mother was a fighter in our family.
Oh yeah, Jet was the one playing, using the blasting jelly. Wonder if she's gonna tell him how she lost her mom. I mean, if you go by the meme, then she says it to anyone she speaks to, but that is simply not true.
I know what it's like to lose family too.
There you go.
Literally, as she holds a necklace. I'm sorry, I can't take it seriously anymore.
Until the soldiers came.
My mom used to breathe. Yeah, and that's crazy that it happened right in front of her. Because in the cartoon, she only saw the body after the fact, but...
My bending.
Oh.
I don't know anything about bending.
Is she gonna try the water whip? I always did love the idea of having your bending come from an emotional source. And having that base be the thing that guides you. Much like Zuko has his anger as his foundation. That was a nice little moment.
What are you doing? Trying some Omashu barbecue?
Made Jet look like a really good person. Or much better than he actually is.
The best the Earth Kingdom has to offer?
Now that would technically be bossing, say.
What happened there?
Bye, show.
In return, I will keep in mind your loyalty and cooperation when the time comes for such debts to be paid.
She seems to be sort of imitating Azula's cadence from the original cartoon, which I appreciate.
Good news.
Not that I want her performance to be a one-to-one impression. I do want her to try to make the character her own, but
we are finally in the big game.
It's just nice. As an OG fan.
The officer on Prince Zuko's crew, the one who slipped you the information about the Avatar, Lieutenant Chi. I'd like to speak to him.
Ah, shit. Zuko shouldn't have been mean to him.
What? No, Jet's not the bad guy. Sai is.
Are you kidding me?
Oh my god.
Well, Jet's a con artist who lied to our faces.
Besides, I saw Sai talking to the
Firebender. They're both duplicitous.
You don't know what you saw. If for all we know, Sai could be working with the King's men to root out Spy. Where are you going?
To prove you're a jerk.
Oh, yeah? Well, I don't need proof of that.
Oh, Sokka.
Would you like to try one of
them? Not right now.
Oh. Uh-oh.
Jet!
Wow, this is a small city.
We need to talk.
Sure.
Mission? What mission?
You have a lot of players right now.
You were there when we confirmed the Mechanist was a traitor. He took care of his partners. Now I need to take care of him.
It's fine. It's fine.
I'm so clumsy. Are you hurt?
No. No harm done.
Okay, no harm done.
Okay. They just happen to have an identical box.
You're going to blow him up?
Not just him. He's got an audience with the King.
You want to kill Bumi?
Sokka was right. You are the bad guy.
The best way to the palace.
It's at the highest point of the city.
Bruh.
This guy, again?
Go. Get to the palace and stop Sai.
I don't need fire to defeat this boy.
I think this is our first one, Zuko and Aang 1v1. Oh, it's just hands, okay. Aang, use your earthbending. Earthbending, what am I? Aang, use your airbending. It's just funny seeing a full-grown teenager just throwing hands at a 12-year-old boy. That was a completely unnecessary push on Zuko's part. Ooh, yes! That was a sick move. Does this place not have police? choreography is pretty good, I'll say. Aang's moves are very Aang, and Zuko's choreography is also very Zuko. Like, this is definitely a fight I could see in the taking place in the original cartoon. Especially this. What is this?
1, 2, 3.
Yo, I would not have that courage.
And that's it? Why, you've been hunting me for 3 years?
How do you know it's been 3 years? Unless you have my notebook.
Well, that didn't take long.
my commentary!
Yes. That was unironically my favorite part of the episode. So. I mean, in all fairness, you're not assassinating Bumi that easily. Probably doesn't even need Katara's help, but if she gets this, that is perfect precision. That's insane.
Now.
You're done.
Go, save yourself.
What?
Oh no, is he gonna give himself up? Hyrule. You are too good for Zuko. It's pretty badass, though. So much is happening. What the hell? He got out? This is... Wow, this is very, very different from the cartoon, so... I can't even predict how this is gonna go. Yeah. Thought that would have happened earlier. What? Alright, that was Avatar The Last Airbender Season 1, Episode 3, Omashu. When the episode started out, I will admit, I was pretty concerned with how they were going to fold plot lines from three different episodes into each other without it feeling rushed. But as it continued on, and I saw what they were doing, it did feel like it came together there at the end. I think including Jet and the Freedom Fighters here and mixing that with the Omashu storyline is a pretty solid idea pacing-wise, since they do only have 8 episodes and they do have to condense the narrative as a whole. What I am slightly disappointed with is the inclusion of Tayo and the Mechanist. Not necessarily seeing them, I actually think their portrayal by the actors is pretty good, but I am sad that by having them here, that means that we're more than likely going to miss out on the storyline with them having repurposed an air temple and having made it their new home. In the original show, one of the recurring themes with Aang was the idea of him coping with the loss of his people and his culture and struggling to reconcile that with Tao's people and what they were doing at the temple. We pretty much got none of that here. Again, I do understand that they have to cut things for time, but I will miss that original storyline. That being said, seeing the Freedom Fighters and their dynamic slash fight scenes was pretty cool. The actor for Jet nailed it, both looks and acting-wise. I think the casting for Jet is some of the strongest I've seen in the show so far. And I was worried at first, because I've always felt that Jet, as a character, has to be one of the hardest to portray without coming off as cringy, but no, he really made it work. But you can't really get more perfect casting than with the OG actor for the Cabbage Guy himself. Best part of the episode, hands down. His appearance was pure fan service, and they knew exactly what they were doing. Edging us, showing him like 3 times before we actually said the thing. 10 out of 10. On the topic of casting,
Zula's character is one that I have looked forward to seeing with high anticipation. One thing that a lot of people forget is that in the original cartoon, she's a 14-year-old kid. But with the way she's portrayed, it is easy to forget. I'm glad that they got an age-appropriate actress for the live-action part, and I have to say that she sold me on Azula with the little screen time she had. The writing helped in that regard because her character introduction was excellent. Pretending to be a Fire Nation traitor and leading that rebellion into a trap is exactly the sort of thing that Azula would do. That combined with her watching her father burn those rebels to a crisp without batting an eye just perfectly sets up the fact that she never had a chance to grow up normal. I did enjoy the second half of the episode more than the first. There were some really great scenes with Katara and Jed, and especially with Aang versus Zuko. I think that was my favorite part of the episode overall. Choreo was clean. It felt like a fight scene that you would see in the original show. The scene with the lady smacking Zuko for attacking a child felt like it was ripped right out of the cartoon. One of my main criticisms with the show so far, I think, has to do with Katara, and it's about her personality. Katara in the live action feels to me like a very watered down, no pun intended, version of Katara from the cartoon. I don't think that's the actress's fault by any means. I put that purely on the writing. Simply put, Katara in the cartoon has a temper. She has anger issues. It's one of her biggest flaws is that she's very quick to anger. She's a waterbender with a temperament of a firebender. We got a little bit of it here with her argument with Sokka, but other than that, I'm not really seeing that trait being carried over into this adaptation. That's just my two cents. Hopefully future episodes can prove me wrong. But yeah, that's really all I have to say for this episode. If you liked this video, thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, drop a like. Let me know what you thought of the episode in the comments, and I will see you in the next.